In 50 BC, a new eruption at the Kilauea volcano in Hawaii began. Lava flows soon raced towards the ocean, covering an area littered with many other dark black older lava flows. However, how do scientists know that this eruption occurred in that specific year? After all, the native Polynesians did not colonize Hawaii until at the very earliest 124 AD. Similar questions have been asked about other volcanoes I have covered, and as a result, I have decided to make this video, which is dedicated to determining how we date volcanoes and other rock formations which formed long before historical records were kept. Although some other methods can be used, the most effective way of determining a rock's age is radioactive age dating. Three methods are commonly used. Uranium-Lead dating is used for samples older than 1 million years in age, potassium-argon is used for dating samples between 100,000 and 4.3 billion years in age, and carbon-14 dating is used to date rocks suspected of being between 100 and 50,000 years in age. Going beyond these aforementioned ranges is not possible due to radioactive decay, which I will explain later. In the case of the 50 BC Kilauea eruption, the advancing A'a lava flows burned and then buried a tree which is now preserved in a layer of rock. Since the wood is an organic product, we can determine its age based on the ratio of the radioactive isotope carbon-14 to the stable nitrogen-14. All living things naturally contain a small amount of carbon-14. The rate of radioactive decay of carbon-14 along with other radioactive isotopes is measurable in a lab, which is used to determine an isotope's so-called half-life. Half-lives measure the amount of time it takes for half of a radioactive isotope to become a more stable product. In the case of carbon-14, its half-life is 5,730 years. Another way of visualizing this is imagine that you have a pizza which arrived at your house an undetermined number of days ago. Yet, at the end of every day, something eats half of the remaining pizza. In this example, the radioactive pizza stabilizes to air after it is eaten each day. So, if you open the pizza box and see that 1/8 of the pizza is left, it must have been there for 3 days. The same logic applies to carbon-14. If the ratio of carbon-14 to nitrogen-14 is 1:7, it implies that 3 half-lives have passed since the organic product in it was formed, totaling 17,190 years. In the case of the aforementioned Kilauea wood fragment, 77.84% of its radioactive isotope remained. Thus, it had undergone 0.36 half-lives, which translates to a duration of 2,070 years. As a reminder, for carbon-14 dating to work, it must be older than 100 years and younger than 50,000 years and involve an organic piece of material. Simply dating a layer of rock without an organic product in it using this method will never work. A similar methodology is used for older samples via potassium-argon dating. In this case, minerals rich in potassium are heated in a lab and then the ratio of the radioactive potassium-40 to radioactive argon-40 is measured to determine a sample's age. For samples older than 1 million years in age, to correctly date them, a specific crystal called a zircon must first be found. Zircons, when they form, do not contain any lead, which is important. Thus, any lead found in a zircon must have originated from radioactive decay of unstable elements such as uranium, which were present in its crystal structure. This method relies on two separate decay chains where uranium-238 becomes lead-206, and uranium-235 becomes lead-207. Both of these isotopes take an unusually long period to decay, which in the case of uranium-238 has a half-life of 4.47 billion years. Thus, if you have an equal ratio of uranium-238 to lead-206 in a zircon crystal, it is 4.47 billion years old. If all of this sounds complex, you are not alone in this thinking. However, I hope that my explanation gave you an understanding of how a scientist determined the age of various rock formations. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.